What is up, guys? Bisectatron here, bringing you today's video, and we are talking about a Legends League attack that has been destroying the bases I have seen. This is on my Town Hall 13 account, using a special army that is a battle blimp with some yetis to take out the eagle into a queen walk that turns into a basically push with some P.E.K.K.A.s, some witches, and some bowlers. So this is an attack I really like. It's been working very well. And if you guys follow my channel, you know I usually don't cover multiplayer attacks that much. But these are the types of bases we're seeing both in Legends League and in Clan Wars. A lot of these anti-2-star bases. This one starting is a little more of an anti-3 type base, but we're gonna see a lot of those typical ring type bases in this video. A lot of bases, if you guys are in Legends League, you definitely see, or if you're attacking Town Hall 13s in Clan Wars, these are bases you're going to have seen as well. So basically, the power of this strategy is getting the eagle down quickly, which is usually doable with the battle blimp, depending on where the eagle is, unless it's totally situated at a central part of the base and you can't get to it at all. That's usually not the case. Usually, you can use a couple loons to fish for seeking air mines. Then drop the battle blimp, take out the eagle, and turn that into kind of a queen walk entry. What I did on this attack was I basically ignored the town hall, queen walked around it because there was no second layer besides that town hall to really damage my queen or pull her pathing anywhere in a weird direction. And I'm going to use the royal champ to actually go in there and take out the town hall. So everything's still pushing through here. We have the queen with the healers in the middle, which is what we like to see, and a big group on the outside, the king with some witches, and that's okay. You just need enough to go into the base to take out kind of the essential infernos, town hall, scattershots, all the stuff that can be an issue in the core. And once that's taken out, you don't need much more of a push. It actually helps to have some of your witches going around the outside of the base with a tank like the king in front of them. So a king, P.E.K.K.A, good thing to create the funnel on the other side of your queen walk as you enter initially. So everything moves through. We'll speed up to times two and take a look at a bunch of these attacks today of different types of bases and kind of see how this works. But I just wanted to share with you guys because a lot of my viewers are Town Hall 13s. I'm sure they're in Legends League and I'm sure they're seeing these bases in Wars as well. Especially with the beginning of each month, we have the clan war leagues that are going on, and a lot of the clans are using these types of bases. So one more of a kind of anti-3-ish type base, and then like I said, we'll take a look at some ring bases as well. So this is a pretty good push here. You can see the eagle is pretty well protected. There's an air defense, inferno scattershot, but still, this is a powerful. If you rage up those yetis, you can get a lot taken out. And I actually even used a super wall breaker to break in and try to let the queen enter and take out that multi-inferno, but the battle blimp got it down anyway, so the queen just goes ahead and doesn't take that the path the wall breaker opened up because the inferno was already taken out. So got more than I even thought it would. Moving into an entry here, we use a super wall breaker to open that up, and typically I'd have a second one, but I already used it, so I'm just gonna let the troops go through the wall and then use the jump later on to actually get to the town hall. You'll notice I am using two super wall breakers in this army composition. Now, depending on what you have, you might not have access to super wall breakers. You can bring a second jump in place of either the two freezes or one of your rages. It just depends on what's working for you. But if you have access to the super wall breakers, it frees up a spell space because you only then have to bring one jump spell, and that's plenty to get you through the meat of the base in the middle, which is what you need. So everything pushing through, we have the royal champ. I like dropping the royal champ not with everything, but a little delayed to kind of help either keep everything in the base, especially on ring bases. The champ is a great funneler. She'll help take out defenses that'll keep your main push going into the core. And she can also take out kind of the side of the base, help wrap it up as your troops are pushing through. Tank for witches. There's lots of different uses of the royal champ, so that's why I like to wait on her a little bit and just see where she's best used. Because towards the end of the attack is when she's really at her most powerful, when she's able to kind of take out these defenses without being targeted a whole lot and get value from her ability. All right, moving along, we will take a look at this next one here. And I'm sure this is a type of base you guys have seen a bit of with that town hall in the middle. And really, it can be tricky sometimes, but I like just to go for it. You know, 3-star, maybe a 1-star, but it's a little risky. But I think if you do the right techniques here, you can at least get the 2-star most of the time. And you can see the battle blimp goes in, takes out the eagle. I drop the queen on the same side as the battle blimp, and that's something that you'll see me do quite a few times in this type of attack, especially if the eagle is deep in the base. The queen can kind of take out what's behind the battle blimp, that maybe some defenses it doesn't get in that first layer. And then it can also help kind of funnel the queen one direction. Otherwise, there'd be all this, you know, expos and stuff beating on her. Now it's just like one scatter shot. So you can kind of use the two different things complementary to each other, using the battle blimp and then the queen walk behind it to take out what the battle blimp didn't get, and then transition into some kind of push into the base. So went ahead and, you know, made it an even bigger charge by using one of my super wall breakers to let her in, take out a few of those defenses, plus using a rage on her. And then I'm going to, I think, pop the ability early, if I remember correctly, which maybe didn't need to do because she was going to exit the base anyway and walk around, getting away from that single inferno. King, once again, creating the funnel on the other side with some witches behind him. Main push going into the base here. And you can see the royal champ supporting behind the king, like I said, going to help take out these outer defenses, keep everything pushing towards the town hall instead of kind of coming out to where the king is. On these types of bases, it's really important that you not necessarily have a great funnel on either side, because it's hard to funnel all the way to the town hall because there's so many layers of base and there's not a whole lot to pull them in. But if, as long as you have a lot walking on the outside and you have your queen on the inside, you can see right there she stepped up, took out the town hall. Benefit of having the jump to let her get closer to it. So just, you know, have stuff on the outside to wrap up the base. That's why I like the witches. They're a great thing to walk on the outside behind the king. And that'll keep your queen and P.E.K.K.A.s and everything close enough that they can take out the town hall at some point. Sometimes you want to be patient on that jump. Don't drop it initially. Wait for your troops to kind of split one way or the other, and drop the jump right as you see they might have a chance of going towards the town hall. If you drop it right away, they might miss it, then you'll never have a chance to open up the opportunity for them to go back into the town hall. So you want to be just cognizant of that as you're using your jump spell. This type of base has these like islands on all the different sides, and there's lots of variations of it, but this is just one of them. Typically what I like to do is use the blimp to take out one of these islands, and then if it's just like an Inferno Tower, the Yetis will get even more defenses taken out, and you can see right here they grab, I think, the Sweeper, a Cannon, a couple other things. You can follow up with some Wizards behind them. Also, I like poison. If the CC comes out right away, I like poisoning the troops as they attack the Yetis, because oftentimes there'll be enough time for the poison to take out almost the entire CC. Instead of waiting and letting it come out to the Queen, you poison it when it's nice and compact, and you can get everything in the poison. So I did a queen walk behind the blimp, and then the king on the other side as usual. Slightly late on those P.E.K.K.A.s, I'm going to have to pop the queen's ability, which is something you want to avoid doing because it can get a lot of value if you're able to use it later on. Went ahead and used one of the super wall breakers to open up the inferno for my king there, then the other one at that junction, which will actually open up a lot, fortunately, and allow me to use the jump just a little bit later on to access that town hall. Freezing the scattershot, raging, and then trying to save that warden for the town hall. Not always necessary because the P.E.K.K.A.s can survive the town hall explosion, but it's good to save for that town hall push if you can. And then we have one more freeze for the scattershot inferno. So yeah, a lot of value from those freezes, and we still have a lot of witches, I think, on the outside. Yeah, they're kind of going through that wall with the warden right there. Champ's moving through as well. And one thing you'll see is I'm going to pop the champ in just a moment before she even aggroes the archer tower, which is something you can do just to speed up her tracking through the base. Is just use that ability. Even if, as long as she's low on health, you can recover that health still. You don't have to wait for her to get all the way up to a defense. So that kind of helps her move quicker through the base here and take out these defenses. She does get distracted on those skellies, which is really annoying, but you know, what can you do? Plenty of stuff left up here as we go through these last 30 seconds. And you can see all three witches, all of my heroes until that champ dies right there, and quite a few P.E.K.K.A.s and bowlers as well. Okay, moving along, we have, I believe, one more attack to take a look at here. This one is another type of base we see with just the town hall in the middle, and it's symmetrical along kind of a horizontal line rather than more of a boxy base, which is symmetrical along a different kind of diagonal line, I guess. So once again, we're going to try to push as deep as we can. Can't reach the eagle all the way, obviously, because it's right in the middle of the base, but you can often push and still get some pretty good value and get very close to the eagle here. And actually, do we take it out? I can't remember. Maybe we even do. It just shows how powerful this Yeti blimp can be. I guess we will see here if it gets. I think it gets that expo. Yeah, it doesn't get the eagle. Okay, that's kind of what I thought. But gets kind of that layer between the eagle and the multi-inferno, and that's why I like using the queen behind the blimp when it's such a big push like that, because she took out that multi-inferno and she can clean up a lot of what the blimp couldn't get. So it's very complementary in that sense. King on the other side, and then we're gonna start dropping these witches in between. Pekka goes down, more witches, the king on the far side, and then here's the main push with the Pekkas and the bowlers. One thing that I struggle with, be as early as you can on those Pekkas and bowlers and everything, so your queen, you don't have to use her ability, because it's really not a whole lot of skin off the back of the Pekkas to take a little bit more damage, so you can save the ability there. Everything coming through, the Warden's ability covers a lot, and I think might not get the Town Hall explosion on the back end, but definitely saved a lot of troops there from the all the other defenses that were activated. Freeze on the scatter shot, and then the champ and everything is going to help wrap up the base around the outside. So everything moves through. This base is pretty much crushed once again, and you can see the power of kind of using the champ on the side and having her wrap up those defenses as the Pekkas are tanking in the middle. That's ideally how things will work, and it definitely works well on these types of bases where you have a lot of spread out defenses on the outside, like this one here. So I think the champ will die. She gets a little bit ahead of everything else, but the healers are doing work on all those Pekkas. A lot of full health troops coming in for the last push of the base here, and we will fast forward as this attack wraps up. Hope this video was helpful for those of you in Champs League, as well as those of you Town Hall 13s that face these types of bases. Really like using the battle blimp, and the witches are a very nice touch that not many people use, but they're definitely helpful for this type of attack. So that'll do it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bisectatron out.